within the United States, we've seen some fairly dramatic changes adding up over the course of several decades. We live in a warmer and somewhat wetter planet than what we did a generation or two ago, and we expect to continue to see global climate extremes.
American forestry and agriculture can play a tremendous role in helping mitigate and adapt to climate change. And USDA brings significant resources to bear in terms of science, research, technical assistance, financial assistance, decision tools.
That's really important if we're going to invoke strategies to adapt to a changing climate. You need to understand where you're coming from to know where you're going.
For example, the 1930s Dust Bowl, a lot of lessons were learned. And so we will have to adapt to a different future.
And we are committed to helping agriculture and forestry be very much part of the solution to addressing climate change.
If you compare the 20th century climate with what we see presently, we have now run off a string of 338 consecutive global monthly average temperatures that have been above the 20th century mean. That means that the last time we saw a global monthly temperature that was below the 20th century mean was February of 1985. Certainly with the warmer climate, we have seen an increase in extreme weather events. We see more record highs, more record lows, precipitation that's heavier and falls in more extreme circumstances, and that can lead to more flash flooding. In the western United States, snowmelt is occurring much earlier than it once did, and that's a disruption to the activities of water managers. We have seen some shifts in agriculture. Crops are being grown in places that they weren't a generation ago.
America's farmers, ranchers, forest landowners, America's rural communities have been very resilient in the face of some very difficult weather events in the past. We think about recent droughts and floods. We think about wildfires. And what USDA is doing is working to help them manage through the risk and uncertainty of this changing climate in a way that allows them to continue to prosper. The Natural Resources Conservation Service is working side by side with farmers all over the country, helping them put into place voluntary conservation practices. One of our new initiatives is the National Soil Health Initiative, increasing organic matter in soil. NRCS is also releasing the Rapid Carbon Assessment Database, and this is an extraordinary new tool.
Well, it is a breakthrough. It's a big deal in the sense that we've never before taken a nationwide snapshot of just focused on carbon and soil carbon. It will inform many of the decision tools that our agency and many other agencies use to make decisions about land management. One of those tools that we have in place now is the acronym is Comet Farm. That helps producers decide where the carbon is on their particular fields, and if they implement different kinds of conservation practices, what might happen, such as cover crops and tillage practices that help build and sequester carbon in the soils.
USDA is developing a network of climate hubs all across the country. These hubs are going to pull together our expertise, but also importantly linked to other resources that are out there, for instance, land-grant colleges and universities, other federal and state institutions that then are extremely useful to America's agriculture and forestry sectors. The U.S. Forest Service plays a significant role in helping keep our forests healthy. Our national forests are an important component of sequestering our nation's carbon. They're important to our rural economies, and 66 million Americans depend on a national forest for the fresh water that they drink and use every day. So keeping our forests healthy is really important, and the Forest Service has a new planning rule that's doing exactly that. It's allowing us to continue to generate important jobs and economic prosperity, but it's also making certain that we manage those forests to keep ecosystems healthy.
If you look at an individual storm, like Superstorm Sandy, or tornadoes in Joplin, Missouri, or Moore, Oklahoma, you cannot blame a particular event on global climate change. However, in certain circumstances, those events may be made more likely by the climate change that we've been experiencing. We have to adapt to the change, and there are groups both in the federal government and academic centers like the National Drought Mitigation Center that their sole purpose is to help producers and others to deal with this change. But people are resilient and are adaptive to change.